Welcome back, folks. We did have a number of requests during the interval. We decided to come back in and do part two anyway. It says in my script that I have to pause now for cameras laughter. As you probably know, folk music often stems from unrequited love. You know the sort of thing? A good honest man falls in love with a fair maid, but she marries an unsuitable rogue, leaving him to pine his life away. Or maybe some poor girl is used and abused by Jack the Lad. He then scarpers, leaving her forlorn and lonely, and often pregnant. Well, for a change, this is neither. It's a song from Northern Ireland and tells the tale of a lovely maiden who's been admired from afar. We never do find out whether the singer or the song gets the girl or not. But in true folk tradition, he probably didn't. But don't let that spoil your enjoyment. The star of the county down.
Couple two.
Close.
I'm messing this up today. I'm sorry for that. Into that rich town, the county now, on a morning in July, down a boring green and a sweet car.
She rolls your lips, your soul, it's your heart.
travel down to Southern Ireland for our next song. It's about a highwayman betrayed by his lover. The folk of 17th century Britain liked and admired their local highwaymen. And in Ireland, when the gentlemen of the roads robbed English landlords, they were regarded as national patriots. Such feelings inspired this rollicking ballad. There have been many versions, perhaps the most famous one by the Dubliners and later by Thin Lizzy, but most of you will know it, so please don't be shy in joining in. It's whiskey in the jar.
I first produced the pistol, and then produced the rapier. A censor and deliver, for you are a bold deceiver. For sure, we do a good of a damn. Wack for the daddy old, wack for the daddy old, there's whiskey in the jar. I counted out his money, and he made a pretty penny. For I put it in me pocket and I took it all to my Jenny. She sighed and she swore that the devil would deceive me. But the devil take the women, for they never can be seen. Oh, sharing the money with her. What for the daddy-o? What for the daddy-o? There's whiskey in the jar. I went up to the chamber, up to take a slumber. I dreamt of gold and jewels, and for sure it was no wonder that Jenny drew his charges. She filled them up with water, and sent for Captain Barrow to be ready for the slaughter. But sure, we never knew it now.
Young man that seduces the innocent girl, leaving her heartbroken, and not this one. Here, a young man meets an attractive girl from Galway and finds his luck is in. She takes him back to her pub downtown and seduces him. Good for you, girl, says. You've heard of Wham Bam? Thank you, ma'am. Well, this was a love toy. Thank you, boy. In the morning, she's gone, and he's left all alone, pining for his Galway girl.
I'm the impersonation of that bloke. So imagine a rough voice.
Well, I took a stroll on the old London from a day out.
the borders and then westward into Greater Manchester and Merseyside. From there, we've sailed over the Irish Sea to Ireland. We're now going to catch a Ryanair flight from Dublin to Leeds Bradford Airport. Yorkshire, like the Midlands, was famous for its coal mines. Before the general strike of 1926, when miners demanded better and safer working conditions, miners worked in unsafe and often almost intolerable conditions. Yet despite this work being hard and dirty, the coal mines fueled local economies, and in some towns, almost all of the men were employed down the pit.
During the 1980s, the government began to close working mines because it felt they were uneconomic when compared to cheap North Sea gas and oil. The miners' strike of 1984 failed to stop Margaret Thatcher's plans to shrink the industry, and the resulting closures led to huge social upheaval right across the country.
Coal Not Dole is a poem written in 1984 by Yorkshire lass Kay Sutcliffe. It describes what effect a pit closure had on a local community. We'll round the poem off with a couple of verses from The Bells of Rumney, a Welsh poem about a mining disaster, put to music by the legendary Bob Seger, to remind us that, as well as providing employment, the mines took the lives of many men.
It stands so proud, the wheel so still, a ghost-like figure on the hill. It seems so strange there is no sound now there are no men underground. What will become of this pit yard where men once trampled, faces hard, tired and weary, their shift done, never having seen the sun? Will it become a sacred ground, foreign tourists gazing round, asking if there once worked here way beneath the pit head gear? Empty trucks, once filled with coal, lined up like men on the dole. Will they ever be used again or left for scrap, just like the men? There'll always be a happy hour for those with money, jobs and power. They'll never realise the hurt they cause to men they treat like dirt.
Will you give me, said the sad bells of Rumney. Is there hope for the future by the brown bells of Merseyside? Who made them my owner, said the black bells of Rumney. Bells of Pina. They will plunder willy-nilly, cry the bells of Caerphilly. They have fangs, they have teeth, shut the loud bells of these. Even God is uneasy, bells of Swansea. And what will you give me, say the sad bells of Rumney? Throw the vandals in court, say the bells of New. And what will you give me?
coast we need. From the lands draining into the Wash and the Humber, there are many folk songs, often involving poachers and fishermen. But tonight, we want to give you a song from the seaside. June's song tells a tale of nostalgia from the times before there were regular flights to the Mediterranean, and when a good family holiday comprised of fish and chips and sticky rock. The Lincolnshire coast was where most of the people living in South Yorkshire would go for the first bank holiday of the year. Cleethorpes was especially popular, and folk went there in their droves at Whitsuntide to catch the warmth of the sun's rays, if they were lucky, marking the end of another cold, hard winter.
Oh. And it's not October, it's early June. So I better take this off. Get ready. For Whitsuntide. A Whitsunting Cleethorpes, sea, sun and sky, a magical moment for two. But the boy of my dreams soon said goodbye. Candy floss wishes never come true. Screams and shouts as the waltzer whirls. Fairy tale hugs as the Big Dipper dies. Ghost train smooches on tunnels of love. A whirlwind romance on a roller coaster ride. High heel stiletto is thrown to the sand. I run helter skelter into the tide. You roll up your jeans and grab for my hand, laughing and splashing to run by my side. A Whitsunting Cleethorpes, sea, sun and sky, a magical moment for two. But the boy of my dreams soon said goodbye. Candy floss wishes never come true. Laughing policemen and penny arcades, the bright neon lights, dancing our eyes, holding hands on the pier as my ponytail twirls, with candy floss kisses on dodging rides. Nighttime strolling on cool summer sands, my head on your shoulder, your arm round my waist. I wish a magician would just wave his wand, then your ice cream kisses forever I taste. A Whitsunting Cleethorpes, sea, sun and sky, a magical moment for two. But the boy of my dreams soon said goodbye. Candy floss wishes never come true. I watch and I wait as the bus pulls away. I miss you already, I want to cry. You blow me a kiss as you turn to go. I wish, how I wish this was not goodbye. A Whitsunting Cleethorpes, sea, sun and sky, a magical moment for two. But the boy of my dreams soon said goodbye. Candy floss wishes never come true.
We are now going to head to a flat land of reeds, marshes and narrowboats. Settled in pre-Roman times, Norfolk was the home of the Iceni tribe, led by Boudica. Sadly, we have no idea what she was singing when she rode into battle against the Romans in 60 AD, but we have managed to find at least one song from Norfolk, though it's a little more recent. It's a love song about a chain-smoking chav called Molly Winaway.
This is quite complex, so pay attention. I had a gal, a real nice gal, down in Wroxham way. She were awfully nice to me back in the old school day. She would smile all the while, but Daddy didn't know all what she used to say to me. Ooh, the garden wall.
Have you got a light board?
she went away. I don't see her no more. Till by chance I see her down along the Maudsley shore. She was there twice as fair. Would she now be true? So when she sees me passing by, she says,
"Oh, glad that's you. Have you got a light, boy? Have you got a light? Are you doing all right, boy? Are you doing all right?
Oh, Molly Whitley, she smokes just like a chimney, but she's my little nicotine. See her and me, never more to part. We would wander hand in hand, together in the dark. Then one night I held her tight in the old backyard. So when I tried to hold her close, she said,
"Now hold your heart. Have you got a light, boy? Have you got a light? Are you doing all right, boy? Are you doing all right?"
The story continues. Off to church to hear the preacher say, "Do you now take this vow to honour all the time?" Before I has a chance to stop her, she begins to chime.
"Have you got a light, boy?
A daddy I will be. So when I ask him what's the score, he says there's only three. So here I go, cheerio, to see how she do fare. I know what she will say to me as soon as I get there. Will she say,
"Have you got a light, boy? Have you got a light? Are you doing all right, boy? Are you doing all right?"
All together now,
just like a chimney, but she's my little nicotine girl.
Thank you. Leaving Lincolnshire, let's get on the M1 and make our way down to London. Let's hope we don't get stuck in a traffic jam. In an early version of our next song, dating from the 1820s, a Cockney costermonger vowed to be true to his fiancée, who had been sentenced to 7 years transportation to Australia for theft.
Most people now know the song as a 70s romp by electric folk pioneers Steely Span. They took it to number 5 on the charts, with the original 1820s version interwoven with the lyrics from another early 19th century song, Farewell Cruel Winter. In the original song, our Cockney costermonger mourned the loss of his loved one by wearing green willow sprigs in his hat band for a 12-month and a day, a traditional symbol of mourning. What is it? Yes, of course. It's all around my hat.
Thank you.
our journey has taken us from the top of these aisles right down to London, and we've looked at the love songs, songs and poems of protest and complaint, songs telling stories of heroes, villains and murders, and songs of grief, sorrow and loss. Rarely does one seem to have it all, but we have found one.
Our next song has been attributed to Burns, but actually all Burns did was add a couple of lines and claimed he'd written the whole song. Up in Yorkshire, they disputed his claim, changing the colour from blue to white and saying it was their song. But actually, it probably originates from Dorset and contains everything we've explored tonight. Love, hate, pride, the effects of strong drink, betrayal of trust, loyalty, loss, and the risk of death on a foreign shore. Ladies and gentlemen, the Blue Cockade.
Early in the next morning,
about Cecil Sharp and how he collected and faithfully recorded traditional folk songs. But he was wrong to think that folk songs should be preserved in their original state. Folk songs change, they evolve. And this is how it should be. People hear a song, go away, work on it, change the words and the tune of it, and then it's passed like a Chinese whisper from generation to generation. New instruments take up the melody and new words tell the tale. And this process is vital if folk music is to remain a living tradition.
So, our final offering to you tonight is just such a song. The original song was written 200 years ago, just after the Napoleonic Wars, when the men who had risked their lives for king and country came back to find rising prices, no jobs, and no way to feed their families.
This song has been updated many times. Our version tonight includes verses by Billy Bragg, Chumbawumba, and a couple of our own to bring it up to date. We hope you've enjoyed the evening. Hope too that you are weathering the current economic climate and are not too much affected by the hard times of old England.
Now all of you tradesmen who travel alone, I'm asking you now, where the work has all gone. Long time I've been travelling, and I can fall on. Tingle the hard times of old England. Shops, it is true. But if you've no money, there's nowhere for you. So what are the poor folk and their families to do? But sing all the hard times of old England. It's a shame when you find that the cynical view is not only cynical, it's also true. Why have one Tory party when you can have two? Then all the hard times of old England. In Costock Square Meadow there's 40 new homes, where the cuckoo once nested, the badger once roamed. But I'd rather one hedgehog than 10 garden gnomes. Sing all the hard times of old England, in old England, very hard times. And now to conclude
Taking a time out from the folk club just to sort of, you know, have a bit of fresh air does for you anyway. But it's what it was that grew into tonight. And to both John and Nat at the Bull's Head, who have given us their room to rehearse and rehearse and rehearse for tonight's performance at the Bull's Head. Also to a bit of name dropping here, to Boff Whalley of Chumbawumba, after all. It was his insane ramblings to me over the internet in some email in the early part of last August that sort of started to encourage a direction to this. But definitely to Jo for making those ramblings into something approaching a presentable presentation. For those of you who don't know, this is our hard liner, and quite honestly, we need her, really. We do. You couldn't have. To John Collins. John, are you there? Hiding behind the bar? And your daughter-in-law who've done the bar tonight and helped me so much to get all the infrastructure ready tonight down here. Couldn't have done it without you either, John.
Yeah.
It would be unfair for us not to thank you for the loan of your PA and for feeding us through the winter. The other members of the Eastleigh Folkies who aren't up here, like Frank, like Phil, like Patrick, who just helped by genius on the way, keeping us going. Yeah. Sorry, and Ian, you're in the mentor. Yeah, the people who have actually helped from behind the scenes, fantastic, yeah. And to Cancer Research for their support and publicity and helping us actually get the word about tonight. And most of all, you lot! We couldn't have done it without you.
Can I just say,
in response to all that, as a member of Costock Locals, I've been here since 1961, so I think I've covered that.
Oh,
I'd like to thank these brave group for coming out here and putting on this performance. And charity, you couldn't do better. I've unfortunately lost my late wife to cancer some 10 years ago. I'm only just to say this, but I do appreciate what you're doing for the charity. I appreciate that you're so great. The only thing that really disappoints me, the cost of as big as it is, there's only a handful of locals here that I call locals. Now, I've lived here since 1961. Unfortunately, I don't know many of you. Chappie came and knocked on my door. Bought me these two tickets, and I felt quite embarrassed. I didn't know the chap. You know,
been here 10 years.
He's still a comer.
I mean, I came to Costock, I could walk down Costock, and I could say hello to everybody, because I knew I could walk to Eastleigh, I was born there, and I could say hello to everybody. And that's gone out of all proportion, Eastleigh. Costock, well, we'll keep it just as big as it is.
Well, you still said hello to me.
Appreciate what you've done. Good luck to you as a group.
Thank you very much.
then, does that mean that we will be able to perform here again? We would do, book us.
Next Tuesday, anybody who doesn't know, there's a folk club at Eastleigh in the Bull's Head. Please come on, if you think you can. 8 o'clock, yeah. You come on, son, you find nobody there, come find my stage.
Thank you for being a lovely audience, the best we can.